It's nice.
Right, and everybody, it's good to see you all again. Sue and I have got ourselves ready. We're going to have our service of remembrance.
No.
The plan is that service of remembrance will get to 11 o'clock in time to have the 2 minute silence. There are a couple of songs for us to listen to during Sue's prayers during this part of the service, but everything will be appearing on your screens. Okay. So I'm going to mute everybody and then I'm going to hand over to Sue for this next half hour or so. Okay, then Sue. Do you want to say hello? And then I'll get the try and get the PowerPoint up for you.
Good morning, everyone. I can't hear any of you because you're muted, but it's lovely to be here with you at Normandy. So, and I hope you enjoy the remembrance service. I've never done one before. This was going to be our first one at the church before lockdown. And we're going to be going outside about 10 to 11 to our prayer tree, which we've made into a remembrance tree covered in poppies. So hopefully you'll be able to see that as well. And we'll have our 2 minute silence out by the tree. So Graham, can you...
Okay,
lovely. As we gather in silence together at our remembrance service, we remember the words that were told to us, that God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in our times of trouble. Lord, I lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Remembrance honours those who serve to defend our democratic freedoms and way of life. We unite across faiths, cultures, and backgrounds to remember the service and sacrifice of the armed forces community from Britain and the Commonwealth. We will remember them. We remember the sacrifice of the armed forces community from Britain and the Commonwealth. We pay tribute to the special contribution of families and of the emergency services. We acknowledge innocent civilians who have lost their lives in conflict and acts of terrorism. We meet in the presence of God. We commit ourselves to work in repentance and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may, together, live in freedom, justice, and peace. We pray for all who, in bereavement, disability, and pain, continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts, past and present, have been given and taken away. Ago, I wrote a modern day version of Abide With Me, which I want to share with you now. Stay with me as evening fast approaches. The darkness surrounds me, Lord. Stay with me. When no one else can help or offer any comfort, O Lord of the helpless, stay with me. Quickly comes the end of each moment of the day. The world has lost its joy, its glory gone away. Change, war, and death in all around I see. O Lord, who never changes, stay with me. I need you, Lord, near me every passing hour. Who but you can defeat Satan's power? Who, like you, my guide and help can be. Through cloud and sunshine, Lord, stay with me. I fear no enemy with you beside me. Burdens have no weight and tears no bitterness. There is no fear in death or life's end at the grave. I will be victorious if you stay with me. Hold out your cross, Lord, as I close my eyes. Shine through this gloom and show me heaven's skies. At last the morning breaks and the dark shadows leave. In life, in death, O Lord, stay with me. Hear these words from the New Testament in John 14. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God. May God give peace.
God give peace.
For those who love them in death as in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace.
God give peace.
For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace.
God give peace.
Darkness.
O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us all join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people, and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen.
Okay, what we're going to do now, gather by the prayer tree. So what we're going to do now, I'm going to take you for a little walk. Those of us who know Emmanuel Church Normandy very well, that's what the front of the church looks like. We've had to move the communion table. But we're going to go for a little walk out the door. Come with me. I'll come in and get the lectern in a minute. Thank you, Sue. Oh. This is our car park. But round the corner, we've got an area where we've been inviting. We've been inviting folk in the Normandy area to come and hang prayer requests on our prayer tree. And people have been doing that over this last year, well, year and a half, isn't it, Sue? Year? How long have we had the prayer tree?
Yeah,
about a year. Yeah. But for Remembrance Sunday, our elder, Sue suggested, and our elders agreed that we would invite people to colour in poppies and hang them on our prayer tree. If I stand back a bit, and then you'll be able to see it in all its glory. It says at the front, lest we forget. Sue, do you want to sort of read through some of the poppies? We're not going to read through all of them.
Donna Louise, unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear. In loving memory of Grandpa Perry, who worked as a stretcher bearer in World War I, he received an award for his bravery. God bless you, Grandpa. One here. For all those who lost their lives in the World Wars, Arthur, ex-RAF. Remember those who served before, remember those who are no more. We will remember them.
Can I read this one out?
This one?
That one.
In loving memory of my darling mummy, who was 11 when the Second World War started, she was evacuated from North London and to the Lake District. Sadly, she was very unhappy and ran away twice. Oh dear. There's another one here. This one. In memory of Pilot Officer Humphrey Gordon Sherwood, aged 19, of Caversham, Reading, pilot of a Halifax bomber on its first mission. They were shot down by fighter pilot Hauptmann Wilhelm Herget over Germany at 3 a.m. in 1942. Pilot Sherwood remaining at the controls of the blazing bomber while the rest of his 6-man crew jumped to safety. Pilot Sherwood died when the plane crashed. The rest of the crew survived and spent 3 years in POW camps. My father-in-law was one of them, held at Stalag 8 camp in Lambsdorff, Poland. But for this young man's bravery, my family wouldn't exist. And I think that's a lovely one to end on.
Can I, Bert and Bob, if I can just show us. And then two very dear members of the church here at Normandy who have died. But Bob Hammond, that many of us remember so well, selfless and so brave, you risked your lives for us all. We will remember you. And that's for Bob Hammond, someone very special, and also for Bert Cole. Bert and Bob, members here at Normandy remember so well. And of course, today, we especially remember them. And Sue, you might need to come a bit closer. Oh, actually, we're going to have our 2 minutes silence now, aren't we?
Or in a minute.
In a minute.
Yeah, okay. We've got a couple more. Okay.
Do you want to get a bit closer and then people will
hear you? Oh, let me stand that side. That's it. Each puppy has been decorated and on the back is the name of a remembered loved one. They hang on our prayer tree as an act of respect and remembrance. You may not know their names. You might never have met them face to face, but each one is loved. We remember those who risked their lives, every second that might have been their last. We remember those that we have loved and are no longer with us. So on this Remembrance Sunday, we choose to unite lest we forget. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Yeah.
Let me just see, I'll just have to kill off one PowerPoint and start another one. And then we have our 2 minute silence. This one here, isn't it?
Yep.
Okay. If you'd like to stand for our, I'd encourage you or invite you to stand. 2 minute silence.
Thank you. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God's Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen. All right, everybody. That concludes our service of remembrance.